Excellency, Minister of Education of the Hashemite Kingdom of Jordan, colleague Dr. Mohammed Al-Wahsh, Your Excellency, colleagues, Director Generals of Education, Your Excellencies, experts, dear attendees. Firstly, I would like to bestow my thanks to the neighboring brotherly Jordan for so kindly hosting this Arab educational looking into mutually common targets of education in the Arab world that calls for an exchange of experience and calls for more openness to the outside, particularly onto concerned international organizations and research into educational aspects towards its enhancement, deriving at a better matrix that is enabled to be up to date with the development, particularly in the technological field that is overtaking the world. It is my great pleasure to thank and appreciate the Dr. Mohammed Al-Wahsh, Minister of Education in Jordan, hoping that our contribution, all of our contributions, will add something new to the researches of this Arab Educational Summit, wishing you all the success and all those participating. Dear attendees, there has been prominent evaluation on the at the level of the Ministry of Education in Lebanon. Since the last decade, we had the Ministry of Higher Education and the Vocational Training, and the, thirdly, the Ministry of Youth and Sports. But today, we have the Ministry of Higher Education harboring all education, inclusive K-12, vocational, higher, and the Research and Development Center and the Educational Development. The partnerships on all those levels and systems is so particular about the Lebanese system, particularly the private-public partnership, especially that everybody has tendency to go to the private sector that takes two-thirds of the students up to the senior levels at schools. The same goes for vocational training. But when it comes to higher education, there is more tendency to the public sector, where we have an official university, which is the Lebanese University, that has more than 70,000 students, both males and females, where 100,000 are, and the others are distributed over 45 public institutions. Some of them are very ancient and prominent that had been there for more than almost two centuries. At the end of the Lebanese incidents in 1990, the non-Lebanese students' numbers decreased from 50% in the 70s to 20%, and thereafter 12% in 2002. Of course, this has not to do with the security of Lebanon, but it has to do with the investment in higher education around Lebanon, particularly in Gulf countries. Dear ladies and gentlemen, the private sector was able, particularly to its vital nature and speed in taking decisions and applying them, to attain development that far exceeds the public sector that has to go through bureaucracy and whatever goes with intricacy in bureaucracies that many a times affect the path. And knowing that both public and private sectors in Lebanon are working together in primary components, firstly, the unity of the curriculum from K to 12, whereby the research center, which goes under the autopsis of the minister, works on following on this curricula depended upon by both private and public sector. The Research and Development Center is also working on availing the curricula, the books, in both public and private schools, if the latter so wishes, according to the discipline of principal of unity among both private and public sector, knowing that we encourage the private sector to have its own leniency, yet to be in common with the public, provided that they follow and adhere to the constitutional of Lebanon, where it comes to other exterior or outside curricula. Looking into the publication houses, they were instructed to issue and publish for both private and public sector, in addition to exporting outside Lebanon and to disperse them among the Lebanese schools that have a high level of quality and also harbor other nationalities. The educational sectors also work together in preparing the unified formal exams that come under the principle of commonality within the two, where so many professors from both private and public sector work together with experts from the Research and Development Center. As for the private or the budget of the Ministry of Education, unfortunately, it is a very modest budget. It is rather low, not amounting to no more than 7% of the public, of the general country budget. And this low budget, lacking investments and enough for maintenance, covers all the salaries and operational costs up to 90% of the budget of the ministry. Not to mention that private schools get no more than 2%, hence leaving very little for equipping and maintenance, less than 2%. There are so many loans and grants that are working to enhance the quality of education in Lebanon, particularly where it comes to supporting the public budget of the country or general budget. Ladies and gentlemen, the educational sector in Lebanon is an investment, many-faceted investment, multifaceted. It is a general investment in human capital that comprises the first fortune of Lebanon, in addition to all of its people outside Lebanon, based on the goal to export an enabled Lebanese person that speaks more than one language and can prove him or herself in creativity and other aspects inside, outside Lebanon. And this gave Lebanon its famous educational and particular educational sector among other Arab countries, hence becoming a destination from other Arab students. Those successful institutions are attracting high investments for buildings and selection of best human resources, in addition to follow-up in qualifying those cadres, in addition to updates in technological and technical curricula, content, and other, and what goes along with it from expenditure on experts in order to keep the pioneering position and continued success of Lebanon. Dear ladies and gentlemen, the finance of education is one of the pillars of economic growth and combating poverty and tolerance in communities. It is a well-known fact that developing education and higher education in the MENA region, Middle East and North Africa, is getting harder and harder for lack of available resources that are specialized for these sectors from the public side. And it is expected to get worse because of the ongoing challenges facing most of the countries of the region, particularly the increased demand on enhanced qualitative education, in addition to other democratic pressures and knowledge-based initiatives. As for the higher educational institutions, there are partnership programs inside outside Lebanon that are witnessing enhancements and high level of expenditures and exchange of students and teachers, in addition to ongoing networking with international organizations in order to avail opportunities for graduates while being adamant to meet the variant needs of the markets, particularly after entering the digital era and knowledge era and unlimited expenditures on these issues. The institute in Lebanon has therefore are looking forward for mutual partnerships, exchange of information and knowledge, so that it is comprising a good platform for investment and investing money, so that it is participating in all international exhibitions, last of which was in London for educational resources and means of education. We should denote here that properly preparing human capital in Lebanon led to the establishment of companies all over Lebanon that are basically dependent on a high-speed internet, working in all programs and programming and technological products that are being marketed inside, outside Lebanon, in addition to other computing and accounting, etc., that depend on qualified graduates. In addition to all of that, we have qualified cards that are being that are graduating, and other special from this Lebanese public university and other private universities that are being sought by many national and regional and international institutions. Ladies and gentlemen, undoubtedly, the diversion towards digital content and digital books derive up until reaching to online examinations and distant learning has opened wide horizons in the industry of manufactured human being, i.e. human capital in Lebanon. And outside, the alphabetical literacy is no more, and we are now talking about ICT literacy. And what remains is to work to attain quality on all levels and within the different aspects of education, starting from the primary to the secondary, passing through vocational and particularly higher education. Here, I would like to suggest or recommend that qualitative education up until institutionalized systems should be the topic of this Arab Education Summit where we are here meeting today. Please, I ask all members and participants from neighboring friendly Arab countries to look closely into the quality and take all necessary aspects, looking at best practices in other Arab countries and to look for qualitative, standardized, high-quality international institution in order to attain higher level of education in the Arab world. Once again, I thank you for your kind invitation, wishing you all the success. Thank you so much.